Do you have questions about how to create a really productive work and home life balance? We're going to talk about that right now. Hi, everybody. I'm Lee Hall from teachingacademia.com, and I'm all about giving you the tools you need to navigate academia and make your best impact. So this is the final video in a series of videos about how to be successful when you're just starting out on a tenure track. And what I want to talk to you about today is that work-life balance that I'm sure you already experienced in grad school trying to figure that out. You're going to need to rethink that as you transition to a tenure track job. And I'm sure you've read about it and talked a lot about it with mentors and friends as well. So let's think about a few things. First of all, what you want to avoid here, okay, our goal here is we don't want you just working all the time, right? Because one of the downsides of a job like being in academia, right, is outside of having, you do have something scheduled, right? Like your classes are scheduled. You might have some standing meetings that are scheduled. You might have some data collection that is scheduled. But a lot of things are up to you, right, to figure out when you're going to do it. It's up to you to figure out when you're going to plan for your class, grade your papers, do data analysis, do your writing, etc., right? That ball is in your court entirely. On the other hand, right, so with something like that, right, you can end up just kind of working all the time because you always have something to do. There will always be something to do, all right? So we don't want you to work all the time and get burnout. That's not good. On the other hand, I've seen people who have sort of crashed and burned and not gotten tenure because they have such great flexibility in terms of when and how they structure their lives that they think in regards to their work, oh, I can do that later. I can go grocery shopping in the middle of the day. I can go to the movies in the middle of the day. I can take trips. I can do this. I can do that. And they don't get their work done in such a way that allows them to be productive and get tenure. So we don't want either one of those extremes happening to you, right? That's what we want to avoid. So how do you create a nice work-life balance? Now, I'm going to tell you what I did, and then you should modify this, right, to fit your life circumstances. So what I did was I made a schedule, and I highly recommend you make a schedule. It does not have to be what I made as a schedule, but it needs to be one that works and fits into your life. For example, I did not want to work on the weekends. Maybe working on the weekends is really when you need to work. Maybe that's when you get your best writing done. Maybe that fits your lifestyle. That's fine. The day that you work isn't so important. It's the fact that you've got a structure in place that supports your work. I wanted to keep regular hours, kind of like a 9 to 5, Monday through Friday, but I also knew that I wrote best in the morning and I wanted to be sitting down and writing somewhere between 7 and no later than 8 a.m. So I set up my schedule to accommodate that, right? Some people write best at night. So structure your schedule that way, you know, and then you're going to have to balance your family commitments, any other, you know, responsibilities outside your job and what that means in terms of your schedule. You're going to have to think all of that through. And your schedule won't necessarily look the same way day to day. For example, when I taught a lot, when I was teaching, when I didn't have tenure, when I was an assistant professor, a lot of my classes happened at night from 5 o'clock to 8 o'clock. So I didn't want to work from, let's say, 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. I knew a 12-hour day, that would burn me out. So I kind of started working around lunchtime, right? Somewhere around maybe 10, might be a little on the early side, but 10, 11, 12 is when I would start working because I really wanted to keep it to about an 8 or a 9 hour day. So in that case, I'm starting a little later and my work is focusing on different things. But you want to figure out what your priorities are, what your life, right, situation and context is, what you need to do to get tenure. You want to lay all that out into a schedule that is going to allow you to do what you need to do to get tenure, but also allow you to meet any family obligations, any kinds of friends that you want to hang out with, relaxing hobbies. You want to make sure that you've got time for that as well. And what I have also found is that what works in maybe the fall semester doesn't work. That schedule doesn't work in the spring semester. Okay. And my schedule looks different every day of the week. All right. I had myself on a Monday through Friday, but Monday did not look the same as Friday. Okay. Sometimes some of my schedules like Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday might look the same, but Thursday might be its own thing. Friday might be its own thing. So really sit down, plan it out, be flexible. Flexible. That's the word. Be flexible, but also Don't, make sure that you bound things so that you get your work done so that you find success on the tenure track. And if you like this video and you want more, click right here and I'll see you in the next one.